There are those who prefer to play music using a CD player and those who prefer a network player. Who's right? Before we get into CD player versus network player dilemma, let me first thank those who responded to my request for monetary support. Their contributions make it possible for you to watch this video. Please consider becoming a supporter rather than a leech. More info on how to support the channel is at the end of this video. Now to the dilemma at hand. Both types of players are for a large part the same. Let's first look at the technology behind the average CD player. The CD is inserted into a laser drive, where it hangs from a dime-sized spindle held in place by a small lightweight puck. A 780 nanometer laser beam mounted on a sley or swing arm is pointed at a disc which reflects the beam back. It reads the track from the inside out. Since the diameter is smaller on the inside, the disc must spin from 500 rpm on the inside to 200 rpm on the outside, to keep the track speed constant at 1.2 meters per second. That's 4.2 kilometers an hour or 2.6 miles per hour, roughly walking speed. The track is 500 nanometers wide, that is 0.0000005 meters. A human hair is 17,000 to 180,000 nanometers wide, so 34 to 360 times thicker. To get an idea, try counting bricks as you walk over them. The pits in the CD are even smaller compared. And it gets harder. The CDs are made from polycarbonate, a flexible material. They vibrate due to rotation, so the laser must constantly adapt its focus. Reading without errors will be quite an achievement. That's why CIRC error correction is used. And when it fails, the player interpolates, filling in missing data to avoid glitches. When a CD is inserted, it's mounted on the optical drive and it will start spinning. The laser outputs a tiny signal that is EFM coded, that's 8 to 40 modulation. It limits long runs of zeros to maintain clock sync and improve error detection. Circuits then amplify, decode the signal and convert it into I2S, the standard digital audio format inside audio gear. Next, logic and control circuits execute the user's commands. Back to the signal. The I2S signal usually goes through an upsampler with reconstruction filters and is then sent via I2S to the digital to analog converter, DAC for short. The DAC outputs a current, which must be converted to voltage, buffered, and often passed through a volume control before it reaches the output. There are various architectures here. Some rely on server software on a computer or NAS like DLNA, Rune, or Squeezebox. These index music allow searching, sorting, playlist creation, and more. Others, like Sonos and Bluesound, are self-indexing, reading content directly from the storage medium. A network player connects storage either directly via USB or over the network. That storage holds music you've ripped or downloaded. The player fetches music files and usually converts the digital signal to I2S. Then, comparable to the CD player, logic and control circuits handle user interaction, communicate with the remote app, and display metadata. The I2S signal goes through an upsampler, then to the DAC, which outputs current. That current is converted to voltage, buffered, and optionally passed through a volume control to the output. Now compare the two block diagrams. The source and the logic control blocks differ, but the rest is the same. The optical drive is critical. When it changes rotational speed, the motor draws varying current, which then can temporarily lower the voltage on the power rail. This may affect other parts of the player. The sley or swing arm holding the laser also draws power, and the interference from this can affect the weak laser signal. Additionally, power supply fluctuations can impact the DAX clock, and the motor-induced noise can influence jitter behavior. CMOS have no moving parts, but they are not immune to problems. The incoming digital signal must be filtered for noise and jitter. Receiver chips vary greatly, from basic ones to high-end FPGAs programmed by the manufacturer. The quality of flip-flops, buffers and internal power regulation also makes a big difference. More on that in my video about streamers, network players, network bridges and more. Apart from the first and the control blocks, both player types are the same. The digital signal becomes I2S, goes through the upsampler and filter and then to the DAX. While non-oversampling DACs are possible, they are rare in streamers. In more affordable players, upsampling and conversion are done by a single chip. In high-end gear, dedicated processors handle the upsampling and filtering. The best results come from FPGA DACs, where companies like Cord, Grim Audio and PS Audio write custom code for their converters. For a deep dive into DACs, check out What's Inside a DAC Part 1 and 2 and Connecting Your DAC Number 2, How Digital Can Go Wrong. All things being equal, the real difference lies in the optical drive versus the streamer module. High-end CD mechanisms like the TEC VRDS or Philips CD Pro mechanisms are costly but offer superior sound quality. Streamers also vary widely. Some use ready-made modules. Others use single-board computers, SBCs, like Raspberry Pi or industrial types. Ready-made modules typically support DLNA and come with their own software. SBCs require custom or third-party software. As with CD players, quality varies, and so does the sound. If you were to buy a CD player and a network player of equal build and sound quality, except for the source block, they should sound the same. From what I've seen, many who claim CD sounds better simply invested less in their streamer, using it only to test streaming. Compare a €500 CD player to a €5,000 streamer, and the outcome will be predictable. The reverse is also true. Within a given price range, if you choose wisely, both types can produce equal sound quality, at least up to about €5,000. Above that, factors like design, brand tax, and added features may skew the price to performance ratio. I'm convinced that both CD players and streamers can offer equal quality. When comparing, always use a rip from the same CD, not a version from a streaming service. For CD players, ensure it's level and vibration free. Consider using an isolation platform. The more expensive the CD player, the more these details matter. For streamers, use a high quality network switch, a network cable or a network filter. If your Wi-Fi environment is clean, consider using Wi-Fi. Quality power supplies and cables make a real difference. That's it for today. A new video is coming soon, so don't forget to subscribe or follow me on Patreon, Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram or TikTok. Patreon and YouTube Premium members get early access and no ads. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it. It really helps. A huge thank you to everyone who supports the channel financially. You keep me independent, and that means a lot. Even 1 euro, pound or dollar makes a difference. You can use the QR code on the screen or the links in the description to contribute. I'm Hans Beekhuizen. Thank you for watching. And whatever you do, enjoy the music.